When you know how to apply the powers of your mind, and when you are expressing yourself fully, and giving of your talents to others, you are on the sure path to true success. If you are about God's business, or any part of it, God by his very nature is for you, so who can be against you? With this understanding, there is no power in heaven or on earth to withhold success from you. You're successful. When you're successful in your prayer life, your relationship with people, in your chosen profession, and your communion with things divine. A movie actor told me that he had very little education, but he had a dream as a boy of becoming a successful movie actor. Out in the field, mowing hay, driving the cows home, or even when milking them, he said, I would constantly imagine I saw my name in big lights at a large theater. Here's a man who didn't know anything at all about the laws of mind, yet he was using it. He was using the law. I kept this up, he said, for years, until finally I ran away from home. I got extra jobs in the motion picture field, and the day finally came when I saw my name in great big lights as I did when I was a boy. Then he added, I know the power of sustained imagination to bring success. The Bible puts it this way, call things that be not as though they were, and the unseen become seen. I told you before it came to pass, that when it did come to pass, you might believe. So here's a boy mowing hay. He imagines his name in lights, you see, in a great theater. And he's living that role in his mind. It sinks down into his subconscious, becomes an impression. Whatever is impressed in the subconscious must be expressed as form, function, experience, and event. That's the great law of your mind. 30 years ago, I knew a young pharmacist who was receiving $40 a week plus commission on sales. That was very good salary in those days. After 25 years, he said to me, I will get a pension and retire. I said to this young man, this was in New York, why don't you own your own store? Get out of this place. Raise your sights. Have a dream for your children. Maybe your son wants to be a doctor. Perhaps your daughter desires to be a great musician. Perhaps she would like to go to Europe to study under the great Cartaux. His answer was that he had no money. He began to awaken to the fact that whatever he could conceive as true, he could give conception. I explained to him that money is a state, wealth is a state of consciousness, state of mind. Health is a state of mind. You have as much vitality as you've appropriated, much wisdom as you've appropriated, as much peace as you have appropriated. And you have as much wealth as you've established in your subconscious mind, because you must have the mental equivalent of anything you want in this life. A millionaire or a multimillionaire has the exact equivalent of that in his subconscious mind. The first step towards this man's goal was his awakening to the powers of his subconscious mind, which I briefly elaborated on for his benefit. His second step was his realization that if he could succeed in conveying an idea to his subconscious mind, the latter would somehow bring it to pass. He began to imagine that he was in his own store. Imagination is the keyboard to success, you know. The ancient Hebrews called it the workshop of God, because whatever you imagine and feel to be true comes to pass. He mentally arranged the bottles, dispensed prescriptions, and imagined several clerks in the store waiting on customers. He also visualized a big bank balance. Mentally, he worked in that imaginary store. Here's a man getting $40 a week, but using his mind constructively. Like a good actor, he lived the role. Act as though I am and I will be. This pharmacist put himself wholeheartedly into the act, living, moving, and acting on the assumption that he owned the store. The sequel was interesting. He was discharged from his position. He found new employment with a large chain store, became manager, later on district manager. He saved enough money in 4 years to provide a down payment on a drugstore of his own. He called it his dream pharmacy. It was, he said, exactly the store I saw in my imagination. He became a recognized success in his chosen field and was happy doing what he loved to do. The Bible says, believe you have it now, you shall receive it. All things whatsoever you shall ask in prayer, believe that you have it now, you shall receive it. That's a psychological law. Assume the mood that would be yours. had you realized your desire. And as you do this, wonders will begin to happen in your life. You know, Edison discovered, or he knew intuitively, that the voice caused undulatory currents in the atmosphere. And he reasoned it out. He said such currents could reproduce the voice. The idea came to him that inasmuch as your voice produced waves, that these waves would reproduce that voice. That's believing you have it now and you shall receive it. So he developed the phonograph. The idea came from his subconscious mind. Your subconscious is your friend, seeks to heal you, to restore you. If someone is presenting you with a phony deal, there's something within you that warns you. That's your subconscious mind prompting you. Its intimations, urges, promptings, murmurings are always lifeward. It seeks to heal you if you cut yourself, if you burn yourself. It seeks to reduce the edema, gives you new skin and tissue. If your child is very sick and you're completely exhausted and you think about waking up to give the medicine to your child at 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, it'll wake you up, no matter how tired you are, exactly at 2 o'clock to minister to your child. Its tendency is always lifeward. Electricity, Edison knew, was produced by friction. Reverse it. Friction, in turn, produces electricity. Edison knew the transformation of forces. He knew that transformation of force, that the force is reversible. Heat produces mechanical motion. Mechanical motion produces heat. Cause and effect, action and reaction. These are cosmic and universal. Pray believing that you already possess what you pray for. Yes, and it will come to pass. This is the law of inverse transformation. For example, if the sale of your home brought a certain amount of joy, satisfaction, elation into your mental atmosphere, then the feeling that would be yours if you realized it would also produce that. In other words, that feeling or that mental state captured in your imagination and feeling must produce the sale of the home. Because if the sale of the home, actual sale of it, brought a certain joy and satisfaction to you, then reverse it. Capture the feeling, the mood, that would be yours if you sold it. By imagining the check in your hand, giving thanks for it, depositing it in the bank, doing the things you would do were your home sold, all in your mind or your imagination, and then that attitude of mind will produce it. Awaken within yourself the feeling that would be yours if you now realize your desire, and that feeling will produce it. A young boy, a D-Malay boy, who wanted to go to a certain college, had difficulty, and was rejected. And I said to him, you understand this law of inverse transformation? How would you feel if they accepted you now? You went in to see this man who rejected you and said, well, we've changed our mind. We've looked over your qualifications and you are accepted. He said, I'd feel happy, I'd call up my dad, I'd feel wonderful. Well, I said, as you go to sleep at night, feel that I'm congratulating on your acceptance and your marvelous success in the college. Imagine you're also talking to your dad and telling him you've been accepted. And you're going in there now in your own mind. And this man is saying, well, you're accepted. It's wonderful. All right, you can capture that feeling, that in your imagination, that inner mood. And he did that, and he was accepted. Yes, the feeling of the answered prayer, if assumed and sustained, must objectify the answer to your prayer. So that's the meaning, if he call things that be not as though they were, and the unseen become seen. If a physical fact can produce a psychological state, then that psychological state can produce a physical fact. That's the meaning of all things whatsoever shall ask in prayer, believing. Believe that you have it now and you shall receive it. How can you believe you have it now? Well, the reality of it is an idea, isn't it? A mental picture in your mind. So you accept the mental picture, dramatize it, feel the reality of it, rejoice in it, believe in the law of growth, knowing that the seed you put on the ground will grow if you nourish it, sustain it, water it, and fertilize it.